Nuclear fusion used to be a rather sleepy research area, but in the past years there's been dramatic progress. All right, it hasn't yet saved the world, but when it comes to saving the world, nuclear fusion has a pretty good shot, literally. Today I want to tell you about a remarkable experiment from First Light Fusion and what happened at the National Ignition Facility after they made big headlines in 2022. Let's have a look. If you push two small atomic nuclei into each other, they'll join to one larger one and release a lot of energy. This nuclear fusion would be an amazing source of energy if we'd get it to work. Yes, nuclear fusion does create radioactivity, but it's overall less dangerous and produces less waste than nuclear fission. The problem is that atomic nuclei are all positively charged, and to get them to merge, you need a lot of pressure. So all approaches to nuclear fusion come down to building up that pressure. The National Ignition Facility in California creates this pressure by firing almost 200 lasers at a small golden cylinder. Inside the cylinder, there's a tiny coated pellet of hydrogen isotopes, which is the fuel for the nuclear fusion reaction. This approach to nuclear fusion is called inertial confinement. In December 2022, the NIF reported for the first time that they had reached ignition. This means that the first trigger of the nuclear reaction in the fuel pellet creates enough heat to keep the reaction going and consume more of the fuel, ideally all of it. They got about 50% more energy out of the fuel pellet than they shot in with the laser. This is not a net energy production, however, because firing these lasers is very energy inefficient. If you account for the entire energy, they used at least 10 times more than they got out. Then again, one has to keep in mind that the NIF wasn't built to be a power plant, they just studied the nuclear fusion process. Their first success made international headlines, but it's gone rather unnoticed that they've since been able to repeat their success. They did 6 more shots in 2023, and 4 of them clearly reached ignition. With the other 2, it was somewhat unclear. Their record shot was on July 30th last year, when their lasers delivered 2.05 megajoules of energy to the target and 3.88 megajoules came out. That's almost twice as much out as in. Again, if you ignore the energy losses in the running of the lasers. This is really impressive because it means that they can more or less reliably reproduce the ignition, and this reliable reproduction is one of the essential ingredients for putting power into the grid. The other development is that the company First Light Fusion in Oxford has teamed up with Sandia Labs in the United States. First Light Fusion also does inertial confinement, but they shoot not with lasers, but with solid objects for which they use what they call their big friendly gun. This method, they say, will be more energy efficient than lasers, and I think they're probably correct. However, how well their method works depends on how well they can focus the pressure onto the fuel pellet. This is where Sandia Lab comes in. Sandia Lab now has what they call the Z machine. The Z machine basically builds up an enormous amount of electric charge and then very suddenly releases it. It's kind of similar to what the NIF does, just that they don't use lasers, they use normal electromagnetic fields created by that discharge. Americans really like shooting with high power at small objects, don't they? But since this is science, let's not be vague. We're talking about more than 20 million amperes and a discharge time of less than 100 nanoseconds. For those few nanoseconds, the power that flows at the Z machine exceeds that consumed by the entire world. The electromagnetic fields are then very strongly focused and concentrated in a central target.
Charge complete. Arm to fire.
The shots of the Z machine can also be used to accelerate projectiles to record speeds. And this is what First Light Fusion did. They used the Z machine to accelerate an aluminium projectile to 31 kilometers per second. Just to give you a sense of what that means, that's about 150 times faster than an airplane goes. The projectile then hit onto a pressure amplifier designed by First Light Fusion and delivered the pressure onto a piece of quartz. quartz. It's not because they particularly hate quartz, at least I don't think so. It's that quartz is kind of a standard test material for pressure measurements. And their experiment was a stunning success. The direct impact on quartz would have produced 920 gigapascals, whereas the amplifiers increased that to 1,850 gigapascals. It's about twice as much and also a new record for the Z machine. So both of these developments are really good news for inertial confinement fusion. They're making progress on reliably repeating the shots and on delivering the pressure on the target. And if the thing with the fusion doesn't work out, I guess they can sell it off to the military. Watching science videos is all well and fine, and I don't mean to complain you're doing it, but it's not a good way to actually learn something new. If you want to learn something new, you need to actively engage with the topic. A free and easy way to do this is on brilliant.org, who've been sponsoring this video. On Brilliant, you find courses on a large variety of topics in science, computer science, and mathematics. It's a fresh and new approach to learning that makes growing your knowledge easy and fun. I've learned so much there. All their courses come with interactive visualizations and follow-up questions. Some also have videos for demonstration experiments or executable Python scripts. This really gives you a feeling for what's going on. Whether you want to know more about solar panels, neural networks, astrophysics, special relativity, or computational biology, Brilliant has you covered. I even have my own course there, that's an introduction to quantum mechanics. It's a beginner's course and covers topics such as interference, superpositions and entanglement, the uncertainty principle, and Bell's theorem. And after that, you can continue learning more about quantum objects or maybe quantum computing. And of course, I have a special offer for viewers of this channel. If you use my link brilliant.org/Sabine, you'll get to try everything Brilliant has to offer for free for a full 30 days, and you'll get 20% off an annual premium subscription. Links in the description below, so go and check this out. Thanks for watching. See you tomorrow.